So this is going to be a video showing an example of using t-test. T-test is often used when you are doing something with a hypothesis test that's related to a mean. So in the example that we have here, we have that according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics, the mean amount of money spent by a household on alcohol in the US is $565 per year. A church group wants to check this claim and took a random sample of 45 households, found that the mean amount spent on alcohol per year was 520 with a standard deviation of $167. Test the church group's claim that the mean amount of money spent on alcohol per year is less than 565. So in order to get the information that we need to make a decision about this hypothesis, we would use t-test. So we go stat and then over to tests, and you'll notice that t-test is number 2, so I'll choose that. So to use t-test, there are two options. You can either put in a bunch of data values that you're given into a list and then choose data, or like you see in our case, we're given the statistics. We are given mean, standard deviations, things like that. That tells us that we have some sort of summary of the statistics of the problem. So I'm going to choose that and notice that it changes a little bit. So what the calculator needs is it needs the mean of the null hypothesis, and that's the old idea. That's the 565, the information that we already have. Then here is the sample mean. We are told that the sample mean is $520. And here is the sample standard deviation, which is 167. N is the number of households, so we had 45 in this case. And then we're being told is this new mean, you know, this thing we're trying to make a conjecture about, is it not equal to the null hypothesis? Is it less than the null hypothesis? Is it greater than the null hypothesis? And we can see that we see the words is less than. So we are going to choose less than. I've got to make sure we press equal so it's highlighted. And then we just go down and we calculate. So notice it tells us at the top that what it's doing is testing that the sample data given was less than 565. We get our test statistic, which is a t value. We have the p value, which is the probability that we would have gotten this sample data or sample data more extreme if the null hypothesis were true. It's the probability of that happening. We have then information that we already put in, which is our sample mean, sample standard deviation, and sample size. So the two values that are going to be most important here for you to make your conclusion, your decision on this, is going to be that test statistic and the p-value. So that's an example of using t-test.